location is really everything for your investing property. Hey, what's up you guys? Lucas here from xlwealth.com. Great that you joined in today, because in today's video, I'm gonna talk about how to find the good deals, and of course, in between brackets, finding the good off-market deals. In today's video, we're gonna talk about those deals that you're gonna find in real estate, of course. The first and very most question that you're gonna ask yourself, and that you really need to ask yourself is the why. So why are you buying real estate? What is your main reason to buy real estate? If you're buying real estate to live in it for yourself, you and your own family, if you want to live in your home, it has a complete different reason. You're looking for different homes. It's completely different than when you want to be investing your money. Because if you're trying to invest your money, the goal is, of course, you want to invest your money, and over time you want it to grow into more money. That's the whole idea of investing, of course. So it's very important to think about, why are you buying a home? Now, the moment you've got your why clear, if you're buying a home to live in it, very good. If you got your why clear on why you're buying a home, because you want to invest your money into it, very good. Now, going into step number two, it doesn't really matter which why you have, but then at least your why turns into one of the other. In our case, we're gonna go into the investing, because I invest my money into real estate to be able to, of course, to grow my money, not to become rich. I'll tell you this, investing your money in real estate is not because you wanna become rich. It's because you have money left and you wanna invest your money to grow more over time. It's not trying to get a quick money scheme or anything. It's not like, you know what, I'll just put, I got 100,000 lying around, and if I put my money into this real estate, all of a sudden my money is doubled within time. It doesn't work like that, okay? It's very important. Real estate is investing your money for the long term to grow it over time. That's a very important thing to understand. Okay, so in our case, we're gonna talk about the why, as in we're gonna invest our money. Number two, what you really need to think about when you want to find a great and good deal in real estate, it's important to think about the location. So location is everything. Now I'll show you a map of our country, the Netherlands. Now, if you're in this country and you wanna buy a real estate property that generates money over time, it's very important to take a look, where do you buy? Now, if you're buying in the big cities, which is a great idea because the big cities have almost all the facilities that you want nearby within just a short distance. But the problem with those big cities, if you want to buy property in those big cities, prices must be sky high, and that's the problem there. Now, in your location, what you want to be, of course, is you want to buy locations that suit your why. Now, if you want to make money using your real estate, it's very important. If you take a look at the map of the Netherlands, and if this is the Netherlands, this is the Netherlands. And these are the big cities over here, of course. If you're gonna buy somewhere over here in the top of the Netherlands, or even in the south, or, you know, if the borders of the country, if there's no big city in the neighborhood, if there's no big cities or any opportunities in the neighborhood, I always draw a circle around the city. If there are no opportunities in that radius of a circle, then why would you buy over there? Because there are no opportunities at all. Trying to buy a deal in a certain circle, and it could be even over there. If there is a huge harbor over here, of course, for example, there's a harbor over there, there's an IKEA, I don't know, an IKEA, for example, and there are great opportunities for people to work and to live. If this is a vivid town, if this is a vivid place, it's all kinds of people go there, but they come and go, then yes, this could be a great opportunity. This is why location is everything. If the location is not great, most likely you're just gonna pump your money into a wrong property, and then yes, it's not gonna be an investment. If you really take a look at this, the why, as in you wanna live in a certain place, Now that's a complete difference. Now you could be living in a place that is completely empty, but if that's one of your wishes, then that's totally fine, right? So this is why location should also add up to your why. If your why is not clear, the location will also not be clear. This is very important. It's not always about, you know, I understand that people want to see their real estate, you know, and this needs to be tangible. Like, you know, if I want to see my investment, I could go there and take a look at the real estate. I get that. But in the end, I'll tell you this. This is the German border. So Germany is over here, okay? So Germany is on that end. Now, if there's a big cities over here, then that's totally fine to buy on the border of the Netherlands. This could be in a small town, but because Germany is within just maybe an hour drive, why not? Why is that not a bad idea? So this is why it's very important for you to think about location. They always say location, location, location. Location is really everything for your investing property. All right. If location is clear, if you already know where you're gonna buy your investing property, your investment property, if you know where you're gonna buy, the next step is to research. Your job is to research the whole market. You should know all the apartments, you should know all the houses that are being sold at this very moment in this location. This is very important. You should do your job so well that you should actually outperform a realtor, a real estate agent. That's your job. There are different kinds of websites, even in your country. I don't know about your country. In the Netherlands, we've got different websites like Funda, Yap, Rarius. There are different kinds of websites that can give you all kinds of information like what is there to sell. Now, not only think about the things that you need to sell, so don't only think about the things, hey, these are the homes that are being sold right now. Also think about those homes that have been sold in the past. What happened in the previous year? This is a very important information because then you could say, hey, how much did the homes sell last year? And the interesting thing is, the moment you've done your research, you also know what the prices are in different locations. Now, like I said, in the map of the Netherlands, you'll see different places have different prices and different places have different kinds of neighbors. Different places have different kinds of facilities. It is your job to research all those things before you go look. The moment you've found something that you think, hey, this might be interesting, be sure to go there. Your job is to go and see real estate as soon as it comes online. Be sure to, hey, think like, you know what? I always wanted to buy an investment property in this neighborhood, in this city. The moment the property comes online on a certain website, your job, because you've done your research already, you already know what the prices are. Your job is to go there, check it out. Now, the pictures is always a thing because they can always take very nice pictures. They can use a wide angle lens. They can use a fisheye lens. There are different kinds of lenses that you can use to take a picture on. And sometimes the pictures are either too nice or either too dark and either not good enough. There are different kinds of pictures. This is why it's your job. It's very important. So just go there, go check it out, go check the property out. Now, the moment you go there and check out the property, what you need to keep in mind is, of course, don't look at the property as if you would want to live there. Your why, right? The moment you go check the property out, your job is to check it out. Would my tenants want to live here? And would I be able to make off money using this property? That is very important. So go there, be sure to check it out, go check it out yourself. And you gotta believe and trust your research. That's the most important thing because the moment you buy the property, it is your problem. So this is why it's important to go there, make a judgment that you can trust yourself and think, hey, this is what I want to. This is where I want to invest my money into. So this is a trust that I give into this property. Before you're doing your research, this is also an interesting thing. So before going somewhere, there are also places that have been listed very long. They've been listed very long. They're on the market for more than 6 months, but they haven't been sold. Now, the question is also why? Those are the places that nobody wants to live in. That's why these houses have been on the market for such a long time. Especially in these cases, the places that have been listed very long, especially those, be sure to check those out, because those are the better deals. I'll tell you this, in my case, most of my homes have been on sale for at least several months. Now you might be thinking, but several months is not very long. Well, that depends, of course. If most of these apartments, most of these homes that I bought are in the end all for investing. But why haven't they been sold to other people? Well, I'll tell you this, sometimes it's horrible pictures. So there's mold in the home. There could be a horrible doors or things are broken that needs to be fixed. And people think, hey, it's a lot of stuff that I need to get fixed here. Now, there are all kinds of reasons. Maybe sometimes the price is too high for the property, that it's, you know, that the value is actually lower than the price is actually being set. So there are so many reasons why some properties are not being sold. Your job is to research, why are these homes not being sold? The moment you found that out, you also know the actual price to value, then that's your job to, yes, just go there, take a look at it. And number five, of course, do an offer. You've done your job. Now what you need to do is you gotta talk to the real estate agent or talk to the owner and do an offer. Be realistic, but yet don't offer too much, because in the end, it's you who wants to make a profit off these deals. So be sure to make a realistic offer based on all the research you've done, but also be sure to check with the owner. Now, talking to you like this is very easy. I'm saying this like, you know, this is the normal thing that I do. I do this every day. Now, I talk to people a lot, and what my job is to build rapport. Build rapport with the people you're talking to. It's very important. The moment doing an offer, these people are trying to sell off their homes. They have emotional connections to their home. Now, you, in your case, if you want to have your, you know, investment there, so you know your why, you're not emotionally attached to the home. So the only thing is, what you need to do is build a relationship with the owner. I'm not saying to build a friendship relationship or anything. You're building a business relationship with this person, and you're hoping to get a nice discount. Now, the first thing is, when we're talking about discount, there are so many people saying like, you know what? I'm gonna check out a property and I'm going to nag about all the things that are bad about a certain home. Now, in most cases, this doesn't help you out. But then again, what does help you out to get that discount? What you need to do is show those people empathy, that you really want to do something good for them, that you want to help them out. And in most cases, if you just talk to these people, in most cases, you can just talk to them, say like, hey, you know, I understand that you need the money, you want to sell your home. But the thing is, you know, maybe you don't have that much, or I don't value it that much, because there's a gap between your amount of money that you're asking and my amount that I can give for the property. So maybe we can meet in the middle. So can we make a choice in there? Can we make a deal somewhere? And then all of a sudden, these people, these owners would be willing to talk to you, and you can find the middle way. This is how you can get discount. And you know, you can say that, wow, man, take a look at this door. It's almost falling out of the wall. Can we do something about that? Maybe you can repair it, maybe I can repair it. You know, let's meet in the middle somewhere. This is very important to approach this as humans. Now you might be thinking, are we not approaching this by humans? So many of my clients, when they start out, the first thing is they do is they nag about the home. Never do that. That's unnecessary, because in the end, you're the one buying it, right? If you're nagging about all the things, why would you want to buy the home? Think about that. Why would you want to buy the home if you're nagging about all kinds of minor things? Now, number six that I want to help you out with. The moment you want to look for an off-market deal, the most important thing is just to go out there. Now, I always say I'm always a bit weird person. What I tend to do very often is I just, you know, ring a bell and just check out the neighborhood, thinking like, you know what? This is a neighborhood what I want to buy a property in. I'll just ring bells and talk to these people. I'll tell you this, the most important thing, what got me into this, is because I talked to strangers. I knocked on these doors, I talked to them that I'm interested in buying a property, and most, 9 out of 10 cases, people are willing to tell you a lot. If you're just opening up and you just talk to these people, say that you're looking for a prophecy. And all of a sudden, most people would say, you know what, I don't know anything. Or if you have one person saying, you know, I know somebody who wants to sell their homes. Or they could be the same person himself saying like, hey, you know what, actually you're just coming at the right time here. I'm actually trying to sell out my home, but I was thinking about it. So maybe we can just discuss it right now. That's how you find your off market. So networking works like a best deal. Every time you want to talk to somebody, every time when you want to do a great deal, having a real estate agent as your network person is a great idea. Every time you just walk around, just get these off-market deals by talking to realtors, talking to real estate agents, going around the neighborhood. Several years ago, what I did is I started flyering, you know, having a brochure and putting these through the mailbox of all the homes in a neighborhood that I thought this is a great deal. And this is how I found one of my deals. And these are the six things that I do before I always invest into something. Have your why clear. Be sure to check out the location. Also, always research the whole area. If you want to do a great investment, your job is to do your research so well that you outperform the real estate agent. That's your job. And then, of course, always check out all the properties. If you don't know, if you only know all the information on paper, then you're that researcher on paper. You've never seen the real deal. This is why it's important to go there, to go and see all the properties. What I always tell my students is, always be sure to check out at least 10 properties before doing an offer. Always. If you haven't seen 10 properties yet, how do you think you can be the expert? You gotta see at least 10 properties before doing one offer. Otherwise, you have no idea what you're doing. And then, of course, the expert level is, of course, getting an off-market deal the moment you know what you're doing. And this is all. If you've done your research well, you know how to do off-market deals as well. That's the next step. And of course, I wish you best of luck in this. If you have any questions, be sure to reach out to me saying, hey, Lucas, I'm actually interested in how you do it. Can we just talk one-on-one just one time? Be sure to reach out to me if you have any questions. Hey, thank you very much for watching today's video. If you like the video, be sure to hit that like button. Of course, only do it once, because if you do it again, it'll just turn gray again. So be sure to hit that on uneven times. If you're new to the channel, you haven't subscribed to the channel yet, be sure to hit that subscribe button. And if you want to be notified every time a new video is released, be sure to hit that notification bell as well. Thank you very much for watching, of course, and happy investing. Bye-bye.